The Soviet Union launched Sputnik because both the United States and the Soviet Union were competing to demonstrate to the public that they had mastered this new World War II rocket technology. The only way to prove it is to actually make the satellite orbit the Earth, be able to track it, and that was the beginning of the space age. On the Soviet side, they had a plan. Months before they launched Sputnik, they publicized the frequencies on which the satellite would be broadcasting a signal. And that was how the Soviets were able to tell that the satellite had achieved orbit and where it was. Radio amateurs throughout the world could tune in and listen to the beep, beep, beep of Sputnik. The public at large was shocked. For the first time, humans had demonstrated that they could send something into Earth's orbit. America's response to Sputnik was of great concern. Had the Soviets overtaken us in technology? And were they demonstrating to the world that they had greater capacity than we did? It spurred on a lot of economic spending from the Defense Department to develop the technology that would be necessary to overtake the Soviet Union in rocket technology, space flight, and navigation technology. The Sputnik satellite itself lasted only for a short period of time. It came back and burned up in the Earth's atmosphere in late January 1958. The Sputnik that you see here at the museum is a model presented by the Soviet Academy of Sciences. Sputnik is at the Air and Space Museum as a symbol of the beginning of the space race, where we could talk about sending humans into space.